Hi besties, welcome back to the channel. This is the White Feather Tarot, and in today's reading we're doing what will you complete or leave behind in 2020. I found that topic to be very interesting. It was suggested by one of the viewers here called Deb. Thank you very much, Deb. It's such a lovely topic. I think I'm really going to enjoy this one, and let's pick our three piles together, just like every day. We have one, two, and I'm kind of actually feeling this one. So let's see what we have. For pile number one, we have the Underworld. For pile number two, we have the Hunter. And for pile number three, we have the Forest. So take a look at which one of these three piles you're the most drawn to. I'm going to leave my hand in a second. And that's probably the pile for you here today. And if you feel drawn to more than one pile, in fact, if you feel drawn to all the piles, trust your intuition. It will always guide you to the right readings. And as usual, you'll find the timestamps down in the description box. Click on your times and I'll see you in your readings. Hi, pile number one. So you've chosen the Underworld. And I'm so happy that this card came out in this reading and that you picked it, pile number one. Because the Underworld is all about the nightmare. Yeah, I'll explain. It's all about this archetypical energy of the Underworld, which is fraught with nightmares, like I said, suffering and pain. And so the reason I'm obviously happy is because this is what you're leaving behind in 2021. So it seems like you've been perhaps facing some of your deepest fears, being brave. We're going to take a look at your tarot cards and see more of what type of energy you're leaving behind, how you're leaving it, and what you're getting into in the new year, pile number one. So I'm going to leave this here. And let's pick out your tarot cards. This seems like very good news to begin with. We're going to be using the Dark Mansion. And then we'll be using the Osho Tarot for your clarification. So let's ask with intention. What is pile number one completing or leaving behind in 2022, please? Sorry, in 2021, please. What is pile number one completing or leaving behind in 2021? Okay, so let's see what you have here, pile number one. You have the Four of Cups. Mm-hmm. Justice. Lovely. I love how these two are coming together. The Seven of Wands, the Fool, and the Seven of Cups. Unbelievable. Okay, love that for you, pile number one. Let's pick out now your clarification cards, and again ask with intention. What is pile number one completing or leaving behind in 2021? What is pile number one completing or leaving behind in 2021, please? Okay, so let's see. You have the Queen of Swords with morality. Yeah. Gosh, a lot of stuck energy here during this year, pile number one. You have the Queen of Pentacles with flowering. Mm-hmm. You have the Knight of Swords with fighting. The Justice with breakthrough. And last but not least, you have Beyond Illusion. That's the Judgment card ending your reading. Gosh, I love your reading and I'm so happy for you, pile number one. It seems like 2021, pile number one, seemed like a tough, dark year for you. May I say, even full of anxiety as well, because like we said, the underworld archetype is the darkest shadow realm here. But at the same time, this archetype talks about this shadow realm that we try to avoid or deny at all cost. And always remember, pile number one, that not visiting the underworld or denying its existence altogether is what gives it its dangerous power. And so I see a complete shift in energy here when it comes to you, because I see a warrior now. We're going to talk about this in a second. But throughout the year, I do see you feeling a little bit helpless and stuck, not knowing what to do, falling short of ideas. I see you thinking a lot. What do I do? There's nothing in my hands to do. I am stuck. And it was definitely a very tough situation. And me seeing justice here shows me that there was a lot of unfairness as well during that year. There was a lot of suppression, a lot of fighting perhaps evil. But there was a little bit of denial, not facing your fears during that year. And I see a change in energy. I see this new idea or new beginning of you standing up for yourself or taking action in the right direction, not giving power to the things that are causing all this to you, is what's creating the breakthrough and the great change in the next year. Pile number one. I do see you actually starting to make this change and leaving it behind altogether. I see you fighting for this, because whereas in the past you went from the energy of not wanting to cause or stir conflict, not wanting to face the tough things because you were perhaps afraid of the consequences, afraid of what it might do, not feeling like you have the energy to go through clearing this energy out and fighting for it. And you felt like you didn't want to lose a lot perhaps as well. And you've done yourself a lot of justice, pile number one, this year with changing your mindset of bringing justice to yourself. You have the justice card appear twice in your reading here. So justice is happening in 2022. You're bringing justice to yourself, and I see you greatly standing up firmly for yourself, taking action to be independent and take care of yourself and not feel stuck anymore. In fact, I see opposite energy here of coming from the underworld, coming from feeling like you're buried and there's nothing to be done because of the things that happened, and facing this darkness, choosing the light above anything else, choosing to come out again. And that has a price, and you're choosing to pay this price. And that's the learning lesson that you're going through. You're building grit. You're building an even stronger character. You're learning to persevere a lot through the tough times here. And I'm so proud of you, pile number one. I mean, not a lot of people do that for themselves, make that kind of breakthrough and stand up for themselves like that. I am so proud of you, pile number one. Great job. And I'm happy that you're leaving all this energy behind. You're meeting the shadow. Meeting your shadow of 2021, pushing it out of the way and starting anew with the breakthrough and the judgment in 2022 is seems like it's going to be a completely different year for you. I see you rising. I see you feeling independent. I see you taking great care of yourself. I see you setting very strong boundaries, learning from what happened and setting strong rules of how to avoid being in this situation again. There is no question about it. Having justice appearing twice, in conjunction as well with the Fool, it's clearly showing a new beginning, you coming out into the life, into the light, and to the life as well, of course, and no longer denying the existence, waiting for things to happen, but rather taking command of your own life and claiming back your power. I see 2021 as having had a great effect on you. I see it has caused you to reflect a lot on so many things that pushed you to transform a lot. With this specific Seven of Cups, I see that it pushed you to look at so many things that you've left in the cupboards, left in the wardrobe, in the closet for a very long time from the past. And I see that it pushed you to notice these aspects again and to explore them and not be afraid to face them, because from an unconscious perspective, it was taking a lot of power from you. By denying it, you were giving it power. And I see that this year, as tough as it was, it pushed you to the underworld, to the subconscious mind, to the shadow self, helped you understand so much about what perhaps happened in the past. Maybe even with your inner child, what you were afraid of and why. And are these really things that you should be afraid of? How you would like to grow from that and become a stronger person? I see you succeeding, pile number one. I see you becoming a much stronger person, claiming your power and breaking free from so many things and so many ideas that were unconsciously in the background, maybe taking away your freedom, making you feel stuck. And facing these have now made you a much stronger person, a much better version of yourself. You've grown a lot during this year, and you should totally be proud of yourself, pile number one. And as you can see, you completely changed the way you used to think as well. You do see here, with the Four of Cups in conjunction with the Queen of Swords, you were only always considering different options, never a certain option that would make you grow. An example of that is perhaps having conflicts with people at your work or in your life in general, and they're making you feel like you're not getting your rights. They're making you feel like you're not respected, and you're... And for example, these different options that you thought about was to speak to them privately, was to give them kindness so that they would give it back, to leave the place, even though you can't leave the place at the moment. And all of these weren't options that were serving you. And the only option that you weren't considering was to speak for yourself, for example, and to not feel stuck. To tell them that this is not okay and that you will not accept that from now on, and to actually get into the burden and the trouble of setting your boundaries, putting your foot down and telling them no more, and going there at whatever cost, because you come first. And I do see you've taken that here, pile number one. This is why I'm so proud of you. And that's just an example. It doesn't have to do with people, of course. It could be facing your current situation or facing a certain specific problem. All in all, I see you taking the option that would have been in the past impossible to take. But now you know better. Now you know, no, from now on, I'm jumping. I've seen myself being able to take these certain or specific actions. Now I know I can break free and I never have to go back to feeling stuck ever again. You've really grown, pile number one. And you can really see your growth here. You can really see how much you've grown from feeling stuck and being a victim of circumstances to being independent, powerful, and blossoming, feeling like the world, like everything is in your hands, not out of your hands, that you are capable of achieving your dreams, of planning, of moving out of a situation or fighting a certain situation to stand your ground. Whatever it is, you have definitely grown and flourished. And like I said, and I will always say for your pile here today, I am very proud of you, pile number one. You deserve it. And so in 2022, I see a changed person who's blossoming, happier, stronger, more self-confident in what they need to do to face situations like these. And I see you coming out of the underworld back to life and feeling like yourself again. I'm so proud of you, pile number one. I will not be ashamed to say it 1,000 times. And pile number one, that was your reading. I hope you've enjoyed it. And if you have, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel so that you never miss a reading that I upload. Don't forget to click on your notification bell. And I'll catch you in the next reading. Bye. Hi, pile number two. So you've chosen the hunter. And to me, you look like the sort of person who knows what their aim is, goes after and hunts what they want. You're very focused. And, you know, in general, the hunter archetype is aligning your energy with the creatures of the world, like the lion, the wolf, the tiger, the shark. And with this, I really do see that you have great strength of going after your dreams, going after big things in life, hunting it down. You're very result oriented. You're skillful, you're quick, you're decisive. You're full of energy and adventure, pile number two. Most of all, you're very brave. And with that, I do see you completing a goal this year, a very, very big goal that you had this year, actually achieving it towards the end of this year and moving on to a much bigger goal in 2022, pile number two. Isn't this lovely? So if you're looking forward to reaching, finally reaching your destination this year, reaching your big goal that you have set in your heart, this financial goal or your business goal or your career goal, whatever goal that you have, you're reaching it this year, pile number two, finally completing it, and not only so, but moving to a bigger one in 2022. Now let's pick out your tarot cards and get more information on that. We'll be using the, even the Emperor is on the back of the deck. Wow. So yes, you're in full command of your life. You're completing one big cycle. In fact, we're talking about a big dream of yours that only seemed like a dream last year. You're completing that this year and moving on to a much, much bigger one that is even unfathomable for 2022. So we're using the Dark Mansion for your reading, and then we'll be using the even trust is in your reading. Oh, gosh, I love your cards, pile number two. So we'll be using the Osho deck later as your clarification cards. So let's now shuffle with intention and ask, what is pile number two completing or leaving behind in 2021, please? The pursuer. Okay. Right. So what is pile number two? Wow, thanks. Completing or leaving behind in 2021. Thank you. So let's see what you have. So obviously this one showed itself first. Oh, there are two. So you have Seven of Swords, the Two of Cups, the Lovers, the Queen of Wands, Page of Wands. Well, we have one extra card here from this deck, so we're gonna take it and use it as clarification. Ooh, Ten of Cups, clarifying the Seven of Swords. All right, let's again shuffle with intention. What will pile number two be completing and leaving or leaving behind in 2021? What will pile number two be completing and leaving behind in 2021, please? What will pile number two be completing or leaving behind in 2021? All right. So you have the Two of Cups again. Right under the Two of Cups. Okay, now that's a confirmation. Okay. Ooh, you have transformation with the Death card here. Gosh, I love your pile number two. Such beautiful energy. The Fool in conjunction with the Queen of Wands, and last but not least, Eight of Cups with letting go. Wow. Wow. So pile number two. In your pile, you're completing several things. It's not just one thing. And I'm not surprised. You're someone who's focused and energized. And your life is going at a fast pace at the moment. The energy is explosive in your reading. So one of the main things I see centering your reading as well here, pile number two, is that you're transforming a certain connection here. Perhaps you're in a relationship that is not serving you anymore and you're leaving it behind, or you're developing a certain connection and improving it, transforming it into something better. Or like I said, leaving behind, which is probable for a lot of you, leaving behind a certain person from your energetic field, actually leaving them. And I see you getting into such a beautiful connection in 2022, leaving behind that sort of energy and getting into something more fulfilling, something that reciprocates the attention and the love that you give. Someone who's very equal to the way you think, to everything, reciprocates really everything about you. And that could be your thoughts, your dreams, your demeanor, what you love about life, what you're looking for in a person. You know, I see someone who's equally passionate as you and I, with the two trees and the Two of Cups here, perhaps even forming a family together, because this also is in conjunction with the Ten of Cups, showing me that you will be creating a very happy, fulfilling family together. That's for a lot of you, pile number two. As you can see here, this is truly what I'm seeing. With the Seven of Swords, I see you transforming your energy, moving away and leaving behind manipulative people with the Seven of Swords. People who gaslight, who lie, who try to hide things, to make things go their way, are not very clear with their intentions. It's so in the dark. Everything is so in the dark with their intentions, with their next moves, with what they want to do to you behind your back, of course. There's sneaky energy. There's definitely that type of energy in your life, pile number two, and I see you moving away from this energy and actually finally entering bliss in 2022 with a lovely connection, a connection that feels like home, that feels like a soul family, finally resting from this energy and moving into something that feels like you, pile number two. This is why we've been saying there's a lot of reciprocation. There's a lot of soul tribe, meeting your family, your real family, and finding yourself very happy. It's a very lovely year for you, pile number two. You have the Queen of Wands, you have the Page of Wands. I see you growing in your career or in your business. There's a leveling up with the Fool in conjunction with the Queen of Wands. I see you growing exponentially because you have the Eight of Cups with letting go, and you do have the Page of Wands. So you're in the beginning of a very lucrative path that could be your own business or a career, and that's what you were hunting there. And then you'll be leveling up, even moving away, leaving that and moving into something much better. Definitely leveling up in 2022 in terms of your career specifically and your love life. Both of them are coming very strong. I see you transforming greatly, pile number two, and leaving behind a specific love interest, love connection, crush perhaps, or a relationship that wasn't really functioning well. It wasn't mature. It needed a lot of transformation. Either you'll either be transforming that or moving away from it altogether, and most importantly, leaving behind a lot of manipulative people, a lot of dishonest people, jealous people in your life finally, and feeling happy with your connections, pile number two. So much transformation in the next year, and leveling up and growing. In fact, pile number two, with this specific Eight of Cups, like we said, ending your reading, I see that the life as you know it will change completely. Because you do see here, I love this card for this reason, you do see a water drop on a plant and then finally letting go of this plant and going back to its source, going back to where it's supposed to be, where it's familiar. Yes, it might feel a little scary with it falling from this plant back into the water, but once it's there, it feels like I'm home. This is where I'm supposed to be, finally. And with everything that's happening in your life, pile number two, from your transformation in your career and work there, this is where you're supposed to be. This is where you're supposed to shine, like the Queen of Wands here. You're a very skilled person, and you're supposed to be in that type of limelight or type of opportunity, because there's so much you can give from that platform or that position or that place. And this is your element. This is where you're supposed to be. The same thing here with your connections and relationships, which is taking a very big part of your reading, of what you're leaving behind and going into. And I see you going into your element. You've been around a lot of people who did not match your energy, who did not match your ethical standards, did not match the way you think, did not match so many things. And maybe you were afraid to leave them because in a weird way they felt like home, but they didn't. And taking this risk and leaving them behind, letting go, you'll find yourself in your element, where you're supposed to be. And where you were was never comfortable or happy or felt in place to start with, pile number two. You'll find yourself in place, my dear pile, next year in all aspects of your life, specifically your work and your relationship, going back to where you're supposed to be. You do see here, even the horse is depicted in black. You see it going with force back into the black, back into its element. And black is a great symbol of elegance, of power, of strength, and using light to get yourself back to source, back to who you are, and aligning with the real world that you should be living in. Pile number two. So buckle up, my dear pile number twos, because with great opportunities and great transformations comes great risks and great learnings. And this is nothing to be afraid of. This is only something to look forward to, not to grip so tightly to the past, letting it go, looking forward to these new adventures, to these new endeavors that might seem a little bit scary at first. But you're definitely up for it. You're a very strong person. Pile number two, look forward to bigger opportunities, bigger level up, where type of leveling up, where you have to think of so many things that you didn't necessarily think of in the past with this leveling up. Things like, how do I invest my money? Where do I put it in? What kind of new responsibilities do I have now, being a partner with someone and creating a life or a home together? What kind of contracts do I need to read? What type of people do I need to hire to help me with that? That kind of thing. There's a lot of blessings for you, pile number two. And with these blessings comes a lot of new types of learning that you should be looking forward to. Say goodbye to the past, my dear pile number two. Hello to a wonderful, beautiful future. Your reading opened up my heart and I'm so happy for you. I couldn't be happier, pile number two. I'm rooting for you and I wish you all the best of luck from my heart. May you flourish and live your dream life. And that was your reading, pile number two. I hope you've enjoyed it. And if you have, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel so that you never miss a reading that I upload. Don't forget to click on your notification bell and I'll catch you in the next reading. Bye. Hi, pile number three. So you've chosen the forest. And with this archetype, I really do see that energy that you're moving away from is a kind of feeling that you're a little bit lost here. Let me tell you, with the forest archetype, I see that you've taken some adventure this year, some drastic change in your life. Things like perhaps leaving a country and going to another, or leaving a job and doing your own thing. Changing fields or career, just to name a few, that type of energy. And with the forest archetype, it requires that you first enter it, as you can see, and then you get lost within it. You thought or you think that there's a path that would lead you straight through, but soon you'll realize that you've entered into the pathless path and you're in an adventure now and there's no turning back. So that's the kind of energy that you got into this year, perhaps doubting the decision that you've made, or being feeling like you want to make it through. It's like, you know, a night in the forest where it's really fun in the beginning and then we kind of feel like we got lost, and then we finally, of course, get out of the forest. And so you're on a wonderful adventure now. It has a lot of unknowns to it. Don't be afraid, pile number three. Since this is a reading about what you're completing or leaving behind, it seems like you're finally getting yourself out of this pathless path and you're finally finding your way out and being very happy that you went through this journey and that you've taken on this adventure. And it looks like the year 2022 was starting to feel like you're getting into something wonderful that you've wanted, and now you'll feel happy that there was no turning back and that you were forced to persevere and go through and find your way out. Pile number three. Very excited about your reading, and we're now going to take your tarot cards and get more information and clarity on that. What's going to happen, what you're completing, and what you're leaving behind in 2021. So to do this reading, pile number three, I saw the King of Pentacles here. Really cool. It seems like you're going to be in control of the situation in 2022. It seems like you're going to level up. Yeah, that type of energy. Okay, so let's ask with intention. Whoa! Wow, the King of Pentacles, the King of Wands. Seems like 2022 is going to be a great year. You're leaving behind all the uncertainty, all the these feelings of feeling lost, and you're kind of like embracing the dim light and moving through these shadowy times. You've been brave, you got lost, and you will be found. Pile number three. Wow. Yes, embarking on a new adventure. Lovely. So last time, what will pile number three complete and leave behind in 2021, please? Thank you. All right, so let's see what we have. These are a lot of cards. Let's see. So you have the Three of Wands. I'm embarking on a new journey now. Now that you perhaps got out, you know your way, you know your direction. You feel in command of your life now in 2022. So you're leaving behind all this uncertainty, not knowing which direction to go or what to do. You have, yes, leaving behind anxiety and stress. Lovely. The Nine of Swords. The Six of Cups. Queen of Pentacles. Wow, you got the King of Pentacles, the Queen of Pentacles, the King of Wands. Such lovely energy. And you have the World. You're completing a cycle. This is wonderful. Okay. So now let's get your clarification cards. As we said, we would be using your Osho Zen deck. And let's ask with intention. Even here, you have the Chariot with new vision. You can finally see you're completing this lost cycle, this anxious cycle. It's going in the past with the Six of Cups here. It's a memory. You'll take the learnings from it and move on. So what will pile number three complete and leave behind in 2021, please? What will pile number three complete and leave behind in 2021? Also this one, okay. Let's see. So you have the Knight of Swords with fighting. Yeah. The Six of Cups again, twice, with the Dream. Okay, I see what this is. Courage and Strength with the Strength card. I feel like this is really saying finding your way. Ooh. Both of them came out at the same time. The Nine of Cups, which is ultimate happiness here with laziness, finally relaxing, recuperating, taking your breath, enjoying the bliss. You have the Seven of Swords with politics. Yep. And that's in conjunction with the Queen of Pentacles here. And last but not least, well, I wasn't planning to put a card here. This one came extra to tell us that the cycle has ended. So pile number three, this year was especially very tough on you. I do see that, as we saw from the very beginning, you've embarked on a very exciting journey, and very quickly you realized that you had to fight for it, you had to persevere, and you had to find your way. Because you, with the Six of Cups appearing twice, this was really a dream for you that you wanted to accomplish. And it ended up here this year feeling like it was scary. There was a lot of stress on you. You didn't know if you were going to make it or not, or if you had what it takes or the resources specifically needed to make it. But I do see that you're leaving all of this energy behind in 2021. You're completing this cycle, literally, and blossoming from it. You will have learned by the end of this year so much about the journey and the adventure that you've been on. I do see with the Seven of Politics, these tricks that happened to you during this year were meant to teach you so much about how to be independent and how to achieve your dreams. They weren't there to make your life harder at all. There were just so much essential information that you had to know and you had to learn about in terms of this field and how the world functions in this field or in this location or in this move. And I see you finding your way, because at the very beginning you realize that you've lacked some essential resources like time or finances or skills. There was so much this year that you had to figure out all on your own. And because it was so scary, you kind of thought that you were going to be lost, just like the forest here, and never come out. There were times where you might have regretted what you've done or felt like maybe you weren't up for it. And you regretted going after your dream like that so blindly. But you were right all along, actually, pile number three. That's just part of the journey of reaching our destination and achieving what we want. It is, we can get lost, can get dark in the very beginning. And I see that you are finally, my dear pile number three, turning your back to all of this, completing this cycle, coming out of it triumphant, successful, in command of your life, independent. You will feel like you have done yourself a great service, like you've given yourself the world that you wanted, that you're living the dream that you've always wanted. And so you're completing this cycle of anxiousness. You'll find yourself to be strong. You'll be proud of yourself for persevering like that. You'll be laughing at the tough things that happened, and instead feeling in command and proud that you've been through it, that you fought through it. And I do see that in 2022, you'll feel much more confident in your place in the world and in your life, much more in command of your life, doing the things that you love exactly, and living the dream is what I'm seeing here, pile number three. You'll realize that this adventure has only helped you grow stronger, has given you so much experience about how to handle your life better for your own independence as well, that the lessons may have seemed like there's some sort of trick or unfair evil plays of nature or of life to you, when in fact they were very essential to learn. Now you feel more like an expert, or you'll feel more like an expert in these matters in 2022. You'll be able to advise people on how to maneuver things like that, on how to take precautions from the very beginning, what to do. You may even be teaching people how to do it, or in your dictionary, then they will be newbies. And 2022 seems like a year of relaxation, at least emotionally. You'll feel like you finally found your place, you've set it in, you know what this reminds me of, pile number three. I had a friend who wanted to go to another country. He was in a good company, good position, and really just wanted to go to another country that they really loved. And they heard a lot of market trouble in terms of employment in that other country, even though it was their dream country. And I kid you not, this person traveled to that other country. It's crazy to hear. And he went to a bad hotel. This hotel kind of took his money. It was a really bad one. And now he found himself without a place, and he was very adamant about living in this country. It was a crazy story. He started sleeping in the car that he rented. He went frantically to different companies trying to prove himself. Couldn't take care, of course, of the laundry and his clothes. And he did all the impossible things that seemed like otherworldly to me when I heard about it. And he made it. He found a job. He secured himself. And it was just so magical listening to it. I felt anxious listening to the story and how he handled it and how he went through it. It was a crazy adventure for sure. But now I'm happy to hear about the updates. I'm happy to hear about what he's done. It's definitely not something that I would do. But all I know is that he had one big dream. And he went on this adventure that seemed very scary, and he got his job finally, and little by little he secured his life and his family's life, and he made it the way he envisioned he would. And it was scary, and this is really reminding me of that. Not that your story is any extreme like that, but I'm saying that you've went on an adventure that was very close to your heart. You were very adamant about making it happen. At some point you felt very afraid, but I see you completing the cycle, pile number three, making it happen for yourself and being independent and happy, fulfilled in 2022. So all the best of luck with that, pile number three. These stories just inspire me, whatever they are. And just know that I'm completely inspired by you. I'm in awe of what you're doing. I'm wishing you all the best of luck, great character, great personality, and may you flourish from then on, pile number three. So pile number three, that was your reading. I hope you've enjoyed it, and if you have, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel so that you never miss a reading that I upload. Don't forget to click on your notification bell, and I'll catch you in the next reading. Bye!